गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज नेहा सिंह. स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो इन सिविक्स वी हैव डन 3 चैप्टर्स. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 4, एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज ग्रोइंग अप एज बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स. यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग व्हाट वी ऑल ग्रो, बॉयज ऑल्सो ग्रो, girls also grow, be big, become big. What is the difference? Let us discuss in this chapter, through this chapter, that how the people, we were, the boys and girls were growing in different years, like in 1920 and now in 2020, what is the difference between growing up at that time and growing up now. So today the topic is growing up as boys and girls. Today we will discuss about Samoa in 1920. What was happening with the boys and girls in that year? So the place, I repeat, is Samoa. So children, that time what was happening? The children, the people, the children, boys and girls were not going to school. Like now at the age of 3, 3.5, the children start going to school. But that time in Samoa, people were not going to school. People, in fact, the children. Children were not going to school. So the question arises, what they were doing? When the boys were old, 9 years old, they went for outdoor work. Which outdoor work? Like fishing and planting coconuts. Now you must be thinking about what the girls were doing. The girls were looking after their small ones, their siblings. They were inside the house. But the girls who were of the age 14, they were allowed to go and do fishing. They were also learning the plantation process. They were also learning how to weave. So the girls who were of 14 years old, they were only allowed to go out of the house. Before 14, they were inside the house. They were doing whatever thing can be done inside the house. And as I told, boys, they were allowed to go out and do fishing and plant coconuts. Now students, let us discuss about Madhya Pradesh in 1960. What was happening to the boys and girls at that year, in that year? From grade 6, what was happening in Madhya Pradesh? That the boys and girls were going to separate school. Separate school means girls were going to girls' school and boys were going to boys' school. It was not co-ed like we do now. Go in the same school, we study, we play, we eat, we do everything together. There is no boys and girls. We have co-ed schools now. In fact, our school is also co-ed. But in that time in Madhya Pradesh, from grade 6, the girls were going in girls' school, the boys were going in boys' school. Now there was a difference in playing area also. Like for the girls, they were allowed to play in the courtyard of the school. It was inside the school building. And you know why? Because people thought that they will be safe and inside a boundary, so that the strangers cannot be in direct contact with them. Because as you know, that time the girls were not allowed to go out more alone, in fact. So for their safety, they were allowed to play inside the school campus. On the other hand, the boys were allowed to play. They used to do cycling in the streets. They were allowed to go out and do things on their own, but for the girls it was not allowed, just because of the safety reasons that they thought, that people thought that girls are little bit weak than the boys, so they were not getting much freedom just like the boys. I am talking about Madhya Pradesh in 1916. Don't get mixed up with today's day. Children, the concept of being boy and girl, they are different, started from the very early age only. How do we know? We know from the past that in the early ages, when the children are small, the boys were given cars to play and the girls were given dolls to play. There was a difference because dolls are soft and cars hard. So they were given different toys. It was definite that the girls will get the dolls and the boys will get the cars to play. It was taught to the girls that they need to behave properly, they need to be very calm, they need to speak very softly. These were the things taught to the girls. They were also told that they should learn the household work because in future it will be useful for them. It was taught to the boys that they need to be tough because they had to go outside when they grow up and they have to do work. They should be brave. They need to be brave. They are allowed to go out and do work. And for the girls, the women, all the responsibility of the household work was assigned to them. It means from the very beginning only, differentiation was made. I have given already the examples that toys and cars. Why not the toys? Why not the dolls to the boys and the cars to the girls? There was a difference. So I hope you have understood the topic. For the further topics from the chapter, we will surely meet in the next session. Till then, thank you.